Jimmy Andersen, Deputy General Secretary at Badminton Europe. Now we stand here 2-3 days after the junior event finished in Finland. You have been there. You're back in Copenhagen now. When you look back at the event now, the two events actually in one event, how did it go?
First of all, I think I have to say I'm extremely proud and pleased that we were able to conduct the European Junior Championships in Finland. Obviously, it's not been possible without the willingness of our member associations. It was a risk going there to travel in under these circumstances, but what they did in Finland at the Pajolati Sports Center and what we managed to do, I think it was the right decision to go ahead, and I'm pleased and I'm proud, especially for the sake of badminton and for the sake of the young players who got the opportunity of playing this event.
Of course, there was a lot of concerns also for the parents, for the coaches, for the member associations before this event. Looking back at the perspective COVID-19, the testing part of it, the isolation part, which was actually also necessary because there were some positive tests. How did you guys handle it, and how did the organizers from Finland handle it?
I think the whole setup in Finland was extremely professional, that being both the center, that being the whole flow about how we managed to do it with training, with meals, and also with the private hospital who came to the center to conduct the testing. So they actually came to the center on numerous occasions to conduct the testing. Of course, it was uncertain in the beginning, so saying how is the isolation going to be and how is the testing going to be and how long do we have to wait for the outcome of the test. Yes, as you say, we had two positive cases, but as they were all of them isolated before the test being done and then immediately isolated even further after the positive case came in, it was very, very safe for the rest of the players, the rest of the tournament to be there. So I think it was handled very, very professional by the Finnish organizers. Of course, unfortunate for the two delegations that had a positive case, but they were very well looked after, and I think they can also agree to that.
You and I, we cannot predict what will happen in the near future, not in the long-term future either. What has Badminton Europe learned from this event in terms of handling different situations like the COVID-19?
I think definitely we have learned that that we can do it. It's not easy, but if you want to, you can do it. I think if badminton needs to in the coming future needs to have more tournaments, we can definitely share our knowledge, our experiences. The same goes for the organizers in Latvia who made a tournament, the organizers in Bulgaria, the organizers of Denmark Open, and also lately from both Saarbrücken and from Portugal. So it is possible. And we need to share our experiences because we need tournaments, we need badminton. Otherwise, yeah, it's going to be a big problem for the development of our players and our young players coming up. They need the tournaments, and so we have an obligation to share our knowledge and kind of assist the tournament organizers in the coming period of time.
So we didn't see that many badminton tournaments taking place in 2020. Are you confident then that we will be seeing more in 2021?
I hope so. I think we will always already initiate talks with the organizers in 2021, also about how can we accommodate this together in relation to COVID-19, but also financially, because there will be additional financial restraints on organizers to go ahead with tournaments because of the testing, etc. So we will be looking at initiatives. How can we support our member associations best possible? That being both financially, but also in terms of know-how.
One of the member associations doing a big job the last couple of weeks, of course, being the Finnish one. In, I think, 3 months from now, we'll be going to Finland again for the mixed team championship for the elite players. How are you looking forward to that?
Now I'm certainly positive, and I'm confident that we can go ahead with this event as well. Of course. You can say it's a bigger event because it's the biggest stars going there, but it's also a smaller event in terms of numbers of players and officials. So the Finnish organizers, they now know that they can do it, and we know that we can do it together with the Finnish organizers. the federations that are going to play in Finland in February, they have all had teams going to Finland these past 2 weeks, so they also know that it's possible to do so. I'm also sure that they are more confident now than they were before the European Juniors.
And it's not all about health, of course, it's also all about results. We saw this group of young players actually getting the chance to play some of them the last major event. You have been following this tournament closely. You've also been following the tournaments before this. How is the level actually on court if we look aside the COVID-19?
I think it's always difficult to compare levels from age group to age group. But again, here we saw Christo Popper from France. He was he's a class player already. He's always broken through on senior level together with his brother. But he's good, and he was good here. And he's saying he was also challenging himself by entering mixed doubles. This time he made it all the way to the semis. He won a lot of his matches in the team tie, taking the French team to the final. But I must also say I'm very impressed with the Russian Anastasia Shapovalova, who has been through a horrendous injury not long ago, and she has worked so hard to come back on court, and she just not only came back, she won the gold medal, which is really, really impressive. So really really well done to her, and she really deserved the gold medal that she won.
What does it tell you, Jimmy, that we already see some of the players, actually also non-medaling players, already playing on the circuit, Future Series International, even also on the challenge level?
No, but that just takes me back to what I said before. We need the tournaments, because one thing is to play junior tournaments, but they need these tournaments to develop even further. And if we are looking at another year without many tournaments, then we are really stopping their progress and stopping their development. So for these players, it's especially very, very important that we can play the tournaments and we can organize the tournaments. And this is also where they become better, and saying, yes, competing against other young players, that is one thing. But once you start to play against senior players that maybe have a bit more muscles on the body and can push the shuttle a bit harder, then it's a different ball game, and this is what they have to take to their next level. And this is also why we see Christo Popov being so strong compared to the other juniors. He already has this level of play. He has played against these good guys already, so this is also why he's so good compared to the other juniors.
Five winners were crowned, medalist also crowned, also for the team event. All in all, was this a successful event?
I think it was. It was a success for badminton that we were able to pull this one off. And yes, of course, we would have loved to see more associations joining. I understand the ones not coming there, but I'm sure the ones coming there, having played in the tournament, they also they go away from Finland with a positive expression, with a positive opinion. And I think badminton has won this time, and I'm pleased that we managed to pull this one off.